Paige, when we talk about the opioid crisis, sometimes we look at it just in terms of numbers. 22,000 lives lost in 2015, 169 Arkansans lost in 2016. But what about the faces, the people that this crisis actually affects? That's the goal here at the Prescribed to Death exhibit on the University of Arkansas campus. Alyssa Hagenbaugh, Kristen Thomas, Jake Ager.
Prescribed to Death puts a name on a number.
I tried to give up CPR. It was too late.
Starting with one family. Headphones let you listen to a mother talk about losing her son.
It brings me back to the day that I lost Louie. I know exactly how they feel.
An iPad allows visitors to add the names of loved ones to a rotating sign.
When you see something like this and you realize this has happened to you, it's... it's pretty sad. It's really sad. But you try to get through with it.
Andy Ager lost his son, Jake. Jake was about to start rehab when he overdosed. He hopes this exhibit will lead to more discussion.
I want them to be aware how bad this problem is and how far it reaches. I don't think we'll ever get rid of them altogether, but we can certainly eliminate some of the overdose, some of the deaths, and try to prevent as much as we can through education and treatment.
The most moving part, walls covered in faces carved on pills, thousands representing people who died. For recovering addict Brittany Boyce, it's powerful.
We need to break the stigma, and this is what this wall does. It just shows us the faces of people in addiction, and everyone's affected.
Now, all over these walls at the exhibit, there's information for you to learn. Also, different ways that you can help fight the opioid crisis and get help for your loved ones if they need it. And they've got a number to call on the front wall. If you think one of your loved one needs help, that's 1-800-662-HELP. Again, 1-800-662-HELP or 4357. Live in Fayetteville, Katie Davidson, 4029 News.